lapping up her legend status with big wave surfer Laura Enever this weekend, being awarded the Guinness World Record for riding the largest wave ever paddled into by a woman.
Wow.
Taking on an enormous 13.3 metre wall of water in Oahu, Hawaii. That happened back in January. Laura beat the previous record by around 30 centimetres. And the legend herself joins us now. Would you please welcome Laura? Wow.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Laura, congrats. Did you realise it was a record breaker when you were actually on that wave?
Oh, absolutely not. I didn't even know anyone took a image or a video of it until days later when I opened up my Instagram. I had a message from a photographer and he was like, I just got this photo of you. I think it's a world record. So it was pretty crazy the way it all unfolded. I was just out there. The Eddie I Cow event was on down the beach at Waimea, and that's where all of the best big wave surfers were that day and photographers, so I just thought no one saw it.
So you're saying that you kind of just accidentally went for a paddle and you broke the world record?
Yes. It's so bizarre, but, yeah, me and my good friend Flick Palmatier, she's another Australian big wave surfer, we went out that day and we actually couldn't tell how big it was from the beach because there was a bunch of sea mist and we knew the buoys were big. That's what measures the swell. That swell ended up being way bigger than anticipated. And when we got out the back, we looked at each other and we were like, oh, my goodness, this is gnarly. And we're just like, let's look after each other out here and we'll just try our best to get a wave. And, yeah, I can't believe I ended up being in the perfect spot for that one.
Can you put it into context? Because sometimes it's hard to work out what it is when you're just hearing numbers. But 13.3 metres, like how tall is that?
Oh, it's pretty massive. When I got to the bottom of the wave and I looked up, I just remember being like, that is the biggest thing I've ever seen about to crash down on me. And it's like a building coming down. And we, you know, we wear like our impact suit. We've got a life vest that you can pull and it, you know, there are all these sort of, you know, if things get, you know, pretty tricky out there, you can use to just be safer. But yeah, it turned out well for me. I didn't get injured or anything.
You take on massive waves all the time. You must get terrified sometimes.
I feel like the fear always creeps in, like, a week out, because with these swells, you can see them, you know, on the forecast, and they're like a big blob, a big storm system coming towards the islands, and then you're like, you have the whole week to be like, oh, my gosh, I'm going to break my leg, I'm going to drown. Like, all these bad things come into your brain, and then on the day you just have to try, be as focused as you can and trust your gut and intuition and get out there and try to connect with the ocean. And I think, you know, what I did on my wave was I paddled in, and it's a lot different to towing just because you're using your own two arms and you have to try predict and keep up with the speed of those waves that are moving so fast. And so, yeah, I was out there for about 2.5 hours before I even, like, got that wave, and that was the only wave I caught that day.
The way you're talking about it, it genuinely feels like you cheated death that day. Do you look back on your career surfing giant waves like that and think about, like, the biggest wipeouts or, like, the biggest injuries you've had, or have you kind of skated through, you know, pretty clean?
Well, yeah, when I was on the world tour for 7 years and competing, you know, to try and go for that world title that I've dreamt of since I was a kid, and I ended up giving up that whole side of my career for big wave surfing. And one of my first big wave contests, I got my knee blown to pieces and my family were like, all right, I think ready to go back to competition now. Like, you know, that's what you've, you know, worked your whole life for. And I was just thinking, no, I just want to go back. And I just want to go back. Once I had that feeling in the big waves, I was like, I don't know what I'm chasing or going for, but it was just a feeling, really. And I don't know, to have this title, like, I didn't mean to do it, but it's pretty weird.
Please thank Laura Enever.
Thank you so much for having me, guys. Love it.